So we will begin with heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Yes, you all have to write in your fair copy. All have to write in their fair copy. Whenever we are writing, you have to always write. Okay? So, what is heterotrophic mode of nutrition? We have learned about two modes of nutrition. One is autotrophic, another is heterotrophic. Okay? In autotrophic mode of nutrition, plants can prepare their own food, green plants. Organisms can prepare their own food. Okay? In heterotrophic mode of nutrition, organisms cannot prepare their own food. They are dependent on others for food. They are dependent on others for food. That is nutrition. Heteron means others and trophy means nutrition. So for their nutrition, when an organism is dependent on other, that is known as heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, in plants also, there are many plants which are dependent on other organisms for nutrition. Maybe for all the food, complete food, or maybe for some parts of the food. Okay, few nutrients or few minerals, they are dependent on others. We are going to study about this in this class. So, we will divide it into four types. Okay, so there are four types of heterotrophic nutrition. The first one is parasitic. Second one is saprophytic. You have to make the column like this only. Draw the column in your copy and learn it in this way. It will be easier for you to learn. Okay, third type is insectivorous. And the last type, fourth type is symbiotic. Parasitic, saprophytic, insectivorous and symbiotic. All are able to see clearly. So let's start with the parasitic type of nutrition. Okay, here the organisms, they get their food. Okay, we are talking about plants. So plants are getting their food from other living organism. Other living organism means from other living plants. They will get food from other living plants. So, here we will have a relationship of parasite and host. Okay? The organism which is getting the nutrition from the host will be known as parasite. And host is providing the nutrition to the parasite. Okay? Host is the plant which is going to provide nutrition to the parasite. Okay. Now, this is also known as parasitism. Parasites may, their organisms, okay, they, one will get benefited. Parasite is getting benefited from the host and host is not getting any benefit. Host is not getting any benefit. Okay. So, only parasite is one, only one organism is going to be benefited. Other may or may not be harmed. Okay, harm means when they are taking, drawing the nutrition from them, obviously they are going to get less. But basically parasite don't want to kill the host. Their main aim is not to kill the host. Yes, what do you mean by kill the host? If the parasite is going to kill the host, then they will also not get the food na. So they don't harm to that extent, but yes, they harm by taking away the nutrition from them. Now, How do this parasite get the nutrition? They develop special types of roots. Special types of roots. We all know those roots are known as haustoria. These special roots, if this is a plant and this is a parasite growing over the host plant, you all can write this is a host plant and a parasite. So parasite will produce some special types of root-like structures to draw the nutrition. Okay, this special structures are special roots by which they absorb or suck the nutrition from the plant. Fine, this is about the parasite and host relationship. Come to types of parasites based on whether they take all the nutrition from the other plant or they take only some amount of nutrition. The parasites are divided into total parasites and partial parasites. Total parasites means where the organism or the parasite is dependent on the host for complete food means for everything, for food, water, minerals, everything. We call them as total parasites. What are total parasites? Total parasites, they are completely dependent on the host for getting everything. Pani bhi aap do, khana bhi aap do. Everything you have to give. So that type of parasites, we call them as total parasites. Okay? These parasites, they do not have well-developed roots. They do not have well-developed other body parts. They don't have leaves. So they cannot prepare their own food. They have only some part of their stem growing so that they are able to prepare. They are not able to prepare anything. That's why they are dependent on, totally on host. Example for total parasite is cuscada, which is also known as daughter plant. Amarbale or daughter plant. These are the common names. Cuscada. Now, one more example which is given in your book, you will see in the bracket, in the box, there is a box. Okay? What is that example? Rafflesia, they are total root parasites. Okay? They are total root parasites. They are present. Okay? Yeah, they don't have roots, they don't have, other body parts, leaves and all. They're total parasites. But they have big flowers. And Rafflesia is an example of having the largest flower. Largest flower. They have the largest flower. Whenever I ask you the question, name a plant with largest flower or name the largest flower, you have to write about Rafflesia. Nearly 10 kg of weight. Okay? So this is about total parasite. Come to partial parasite. Partial parasite, they have green leaves. Okay? They can prepare their own food. But for water and minerals, they are dependent on others. So, only for water and minerals, they are dependent. That's why we call them as partial parasite. They are not totally dependent on the host. They can prepare their own food. Okay, they have leaves, they have chlorophyll, they perform photosynthesis, but they cannot get water and minerals because their roots are not very well developed. So, they are getting this water and minerals from the host plant. Example for partial parasite is mistletoe. Example for partial parasite is mistletoe. Okay? Now, depending on whether the parasite is present in the root of the host or stem of the host, there can be again types of parasites for both of them. Like total root parasite can be there, total shoot parasite can be there, okay? Partial root parasite can be there and partial stem or shoot parasite can be there. Clear to each and everyone? So this is about parasitic, where organisms, they get the plants which are parasites, they are getting food from other living organism. Clear to each and everyone? Okay, we will move to the next type. Next type is saprophytic, where sapro means dead. Okay, and phytic, dead, decaying, rot. Okay, rotten. So, phytic is plants. What do we mean by this? Here, saprophytic plants, they get their food from dead remains, dead and decaying plants and animals, organic matter. Organic matter. So, they are not dependent on the living organisms the way parasites were dependent. They are dependent on the dead. They are dead and now they will get all the nutrition from the dead remains. We call such type of plants as saprophytes. How do we identify? What will be the features in this? You will see, basically they are whitish parts in the body. The body is whitish. Clear? Whitish bodies they will have. They don't have leaves. They don't have leaves. They don't have chlorophyll. So they cannot prepare their food. Very well developed body parts they don't have. Flowers they can have colorful flowers. Brightly colored flowers. Flowers they possess. They have flowers. Okay, example for saprophytes, we will see Indian pipe and coral root. Indian pipe and coral root. Indian pipe and coral root. Yeah. So, one very important feature which is present in saprophytic plant is in the roots of these plants, there is an organism, microorganism called fungi. There is a microorganism called fungi, which remains there in the roots. So, if you will see these roots, they are present nearer or associated with the roots and their fungi will convert all the decaying matter into sugar, okay, into nutrients which the roots of these saprophytes are going to absorb, okay. So, they are getting all the nourishment because of this fungi. Fungi will break down all the organic matter. That's why fungi is also known as saprotroph. Another name for fungi is saprotroph. We all know fungi is also known as a decomposer. Fungi and bacteria, they are decomposer. So, they decomposes all the organic material made up of plants and animals. Okay, few examples in the box you will see in your book. Few examples, you will underline it. Underline types of or examples of fungi. Examples of fungi. Underline it. Examples are given. Mushroom and toadstool. Mushroom and toadstool. These are not the only examples. We all know many fungi. Earlier fungi was included in plants group. Because of presence of cell wall. Later on, it was separated and it is present in a kingdom called fungi. Okay, so this fungi is having specific characteristics. They have cell wall, they do not have chlorophyll, they are basically saprotrophs, they eat all the dead remains of plants and animals, and they prepare their food by that. Okay, so in a way, these fungi, they help in cleaning the environment. Okay, example which is given in the book, that is mushroom and toadstool. But other examples like yeast is there, single cell fungi, and we also see one activity for growing fungi. What activity is there? We will take bread, piece of bread, okay? We will moist it and you keep it somewhere, warm area at your home, okay? And after a few days, you will see some green color or black color patches, okay? When we observe it under the microscope, we will see that is basically a type of fungi, okay? And what is the name of that fungi? That is known as rhizopus. Common name is bread mold. Clear to each and everyone? So this activity, you all have to do it. We will study it under the microscope, what type of structure they have. They have hyphae, they have mycelium, they have some fruiting bodies, they have sporangia. Inside sporangia, spores are present. All these things we can study in the class, in the lab, we will do this activity. For that, we will have to take a bread and we have to grow the bread mold over it. Okay. So, in general also, you all must have seen that fungi grows at all the places. You know, it can even grow inside your pickles. The cottony growth which you see, okay, on the pickles, on the food which is rotten, they all are fungi. Okay, children. Thank you, children.